Hi everyone, I'm Zach Reinhardt. Sorry my review's a day late. I was out yesterday up in Cleveland, big road trip, to go see the Acid Mother's Temple live, which was a great show. They're amazing live. Definitely catch them while they're touring the United States at the moment. And I just got back a little while ago. I went and, did some errands, and now I'm finally able to sit down and review this album that I'm about to get to, but important landmark. In the meantime, we hit 200 subscribers. That's right, everybody. We have 200 subscribers, and I am ecstatic about it. Thank you so much for all the support. I had something planned that I was gonna release and give to you guys for 200 subscribers, but unfortunately, it's not quite ready yet, and I'm not sure when it will be ready. I'm most of the way done with it, but it's like a little project I was doing. So whenever it comes, whether it's 200 subscribers or just a random, hey, thanks for all the support celebration, for now, you'll just have to accept my thanks. And we'll get right into the review. Going into this new Dustin Wong and Takako Minekawa album, Are Euphoria? Dustin Wong and Takako Minekawa are names that, I wouldn't be surprised if you knew them. They've been kicking around for a little while now. Dustin Wong is a kind of experimental American guitarist who has been kicking around in various different projects, mostly solo stuff recently. He does some kind of experimental, quirky guitar-based music that isn't necessarily rock all the time, but often is. And Takako Minekawa is a synth-pop artist who has been kicking around for several years as well. And she's probably most known for a single she had years back called Fantastic Cat, that has one of the funnest synth solos I've ever heard in it, just by the way. But her and Dustin Wong have teamed up and released this new album, and they've been doing this for a little while now. I only heard their last album, Savage Imagination, I believe it was called. And it was solid. It was a good kind of experimental, somewhat soundscapey, kind of alternative pop album with hints of electronica and various kind of world music and some post-rock maybe mixed in there as well. It was a solid album, but it wasn't something that stuck with me. I didn't really listen to it a bunch after the initial kind of week of getting to know it. And on this new album, Dustin Wong and Takako Minekawa are taking an even more kind of chilled out, spacey, and experimental approach than they did on their last album. There are 7 tracks on here, each ranging from 4 to 8 minutes long, and definitely leaning towards the 8 minutes rather than the 4. And they all follow the same basic formula, though take it in very differing directions as the album progresses. Each song starts off with a series of loops, usually, that are usually percussive in some way. They're often drums or just some kind of sharp synth stabs that are somewhat percussive. They use a lot of tonal percussion along the lines of like xylophone and stuff like that in the music as well. And they basically build these songs into big, kind of almost post-rockish, but just a little too weird to call it that, soundscapes. They all build really nicely. They have really well-defined kind of peaks and valleys. And there's a lot of cool sound play they do on this album as well. They really like to manipulate the vocals, especially. They are not afraid to do anything from just drench them in reverb and echo, all the way to using auto-tune and weird pitch shifting. Sometimes the kind of spacey synths meld with the vocals to such a point that I have trouble telling where one of them ends and the other begins. That's definitely the case that's definitely the case on track two, Ben Bello, where the vocals are so heavily processed and kind of drenched in all this reverb and effects and mixed in with all these sparkling synthesizers that it really blends into this one kind of amorphous blob of sound that is actually quite compelling. And all the really sharp tonal percussion in this song reminds me a bit of gamelan music, along the lines of like the band OOIOO, which has used various different kind of world music. I hate that word, but you know what I mean. Genres, including gamelan music, in these kind of weird soundscapey rock tracks. The third track, Zaab, with three A's, is a bit more techno-y and a bit more beat-focused. It's a little bit more upbeat. It reminds me a bit more of the stuff on their last album, Savage Imagination. I think that's what it's called. Please mind work today. But this song really shows off how they blend all this more traditional, like, drum percussion stuff with all these, like, weird samples of, like, it sounds like really anything. Like, there's some sounds that sound like silverware being dropped or something. They use all these kind of weird found sound kind of sounding samples that they just incorporate into this big ever-growing percussion loop that builds and builds and builds and just gets more layers. It's definitely one of the denser and kind of heavier tracks on the track listing here, but it also has some very ethereal, spacey moments like the ending. And I really like the midpoint where it kind of resets and drops just down to these hand drums, and Takako Minekawa starts singing these kind of staccato notes that start echoing and looping on top of each other and make this really kind of chaotic soundscape that sounds really nice, actually. The duo uses overlapping loops to great effect on track 5, Akubi, as well. We get these layers of hand drums that kind of pulse on top of each other, but don't really line up perfectly well, and give it this kind of off-kilter groove that you almost forget about by the time you're halfway into the song because of just how much sound is on top of it. But they make a point to bring it back later in the song just to kind of remind you of it. But it's not just percussion they like to do this with. On this track in particular, they also have some really big, just cascading kind of cyclical loops of guitar that come off like a waterfall, just kind of eternally falling. They do some very similar guitar loop layering on the next track, Hahamori, as well. This song is very spacey and ethereal, and it's definitely one of the slower and calmer tracks on here, but it's very pretty, and towards the end it turns into this big kind of vocal collage that's going on of all these loops of vocals layering on top of each other. And while it does go on a bit long for my taste, and I feel it drags on maybe a minute or two too long, it's definitely a very compelling, pretty sound. And they break out some of the most diverse sounds on this album for the last track, Elastic Astral Peel, which has some really big percussion parts and some, I think, sitar in the background, and just overall a darker tone than we hear on any of the other tracks. This song has some really squelchy, kind of weird synthesizers that give it this almost Food Man-esque kind of quirk to it, and it builds up into this big percussion section in the middle where this big drum just kind of steadily comes in and takes over the song. And we get some nice beeps and boops from R2-D2 doing a solo on here. Nice to see that he's willing to do some music work even with all the Star Wars money rolling in. And the song slides into a very ethereal, spacey soundscape to end the album. Overall, I'm liking this album quite a bit. I'm definitely enjoying my time with it, but I don't know that it's something that's going to be with me moving forward. I don't know how much I'm going to be returning to this album. I definitely had a good time listening to it, And if this is something more up your alley and you're looking for something a bit more kind of ethereal, a bit more calming, a bit more, I hate to say background music, but it kind of serves that role, and you don't mind some kind of experimental sound play, this is definitely an album you should check out. And these are definitely artists you should dig into. They have some interesting back catalogs, both of them. But for me, and I do feel that this is mostly down to personal taste and not like a quality assessment of the album, it's a little too zen for me. It's a little too samey at times. Some of the songs work with very similar sounds and very similar textures, and I wish there was a bit more diversity. But overall, this is a pretty solid new album from Dustin Wong and Takako Minekawa. It's good to see that they're still doing music together. And I'm feeling a 7 out of 10 on this thing. It's definitely a solid album. I enjoyed my time with it. But I don't know if it's really going to be sticking with me for the months to come. And I wish there was a bit more diversity in just the amount of texture and the amount of variety of sounds on this. But if this sounds like something up your alley, definitely check it out. That's me. New Dustin Wong and Takako Minekawa album. It's called Our Euphoria. And it's pretty solid. It's a good album. I'll see you guys next week for some review. Peace.